I know some of you are going to be a little anxious about that. Announcements are going to come a little bit later. So we're not going to do announcements right now. Even though this is an announcement, we're not doing announcements. So I'll let you figure that one out. But we are going to begin with a word of prayer, and then we'll watch our opening video. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. And we thank you that you are our Lord and Savior. And as we prepare for this Advent season, the coming, that you're coming, Lord, we just ask that you fill us with joy and hope and love. We say this in your precious name. Amen. So please watch this opening video this morning.
Joy. We hear it and we think of happiness or laughter. But true joy far outweighs any fleeting emotions. Like a beautiful garment, joy is a response that we clothe ourselves with. And at this time of year, it's our heart's cry as we bear witness again to the birth of the Savior. And let's face it, there's not a person here who couldn't use a little more joy these days. So you're invited into that quality of joy, whether your life is full of happiness or not. It's an invitation for every person. And it's here now, because Jesus is here now. This is joy. Welcome to Christmas.
Prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of the mourning, the mantle of praise instead of faint spirit. Isaiah 61:1-3a. We come today as people who are also surrounded by suffering and grief, and yet the Spirit hovers among us, tending and appointing, inspiring freedom where there is captivity, decoring blessing in places where the world has cursed, and igniting fierce joy where mourning and heartache prevail.
Yet we are called to witness to the persistent joy that sustains our life as God's people.
We light these candles as signs of our shocking hope, peace, and fierce joy. May our lives shine with the fierce, tensionous joy of the light who lives in our hearts as we wait and work for the coming of God's kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Amen.
Thank you. week. Good morning. Every week we get to follow her. Nice job. All of us, from the oldest down to the youngest in this sanctuary, have favorite memories of Christmas. In our hearts, we know that what this season and the reason for the season means to us. We as a congregation are blessed that one of our own, Mr. Larry Pass, has been able to put some of that down in the lyrics of a song. So the lyrics are going to be up on the screen, and we ask you to feel free to join the chorus if you feel comfortable doing that. Larry?
Yeah. I've taken some guitar lessons up at the front porch in Valpo, and I was lucky enough to get the guy that really, they had like 100 people part-time a lot, and, you know, any instrument you wanted to learn, they did it. So I was lucky to get him, and we hit it off really good, and he did work in Chicago, back up, you know, and even came, well, when he thought we were ready as students, come into our church, and we did this twice. I don't know if anybody remembers it back then. It's 23 years ago. Well, needless to say, things have changed for a while. My voice is not the voice here. So I don't know what we're going to do here, but and I'm going to make some mistakes. I'm probably going to be retired after this one. So I got another back surgery, so I'm going to go. Okay, ready?
Ready.
It's an old-time Christmas. It's an old-time Christmas, kind we used to know. It's an old-time Christmas, the kind that made us glow. It's a time for families, friendships too, time for singing a Christmas tune, the time for believers to go to church to sing those hymns of the Savior's birth. It's an old-time Christmas, kind we used to know. It's an old to dive. It's an old-time Christmas, kind we used to know. It's an old-time Christmas, kind that made us whole. But God had a plan for the Son of Man, all his children, soon as he can, you can hear his message at the church of your choice. Sing old hymns, all of your voice. It's an old-time Christmas, the kind we used to know. It's an old Spirit of Christmas again, local commercial, it's almost a sin. Receive God's love through the Spirit within, and give it away as much as you can. Then we'll bring back to Christmas the days of old. Bring back families into its fold. So remember whose birth we celebrate today. Thank God for Jesus every time you pray. It's an old-time Christmas, kind we used to know. It's an old-time Christmas, kind that made us glow. The kind that made us glow.
Thank you.
So will you stand for the next hymn, please, for the next song?
Golden lure they gave to you.
I know you came to rescue me. This baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for me and you. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Still every breath you drew was hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Please be seated.
So we want to make sure that you stay after the program and have brunch with us, and that will be back in the very back. So please, please stay for that. I took a preview of the food that's back there. You're going to want to stay, just saying. Because when Methodists meet, Methodists eat, right? So please join us for that. Christmas Eve, we have service, regular service at 9:45 a.m., so come and join us for that. And also, we will have a candlelight service at 11 p.m., candlelight service here. If you've never experienced a Christmas Eve candlelight service, this is your time. It's pretty cool, it's exciting, and I enjoy it immensely. I guess there's no other announcements that I have, but Ruth has an announcement. So Ruth, come on up.
Good morning. Every year, the United Women in Faith award a special mission recognition to someone or someone's this year of outstanding work that they have done through the years working with children and in the church and outside of the church. And this person for many years has dedicated his time to the youth and to many things that he does here in the church. So this award goes, a gift in missions with women, children, and youth has been forwarded to the United Women in Faith office to Doug Walker.
Surprise, I didn't know. Thank you.
Thank you, Doug.
Thank you.
This one goes to a special person who does many things in the church and works with the children, has worked in many different positions, and this special mission award gift for missions with women, children, and youth has been forwarded to the United Women in Faith National Office to Rhonda Walker. There you go. You are welcome. We have one more, and this goes to a special person who does all kinds of things, but has worked with the children, has taught Sunday school, has done many different positions, and so this gift for missions for the women, children, and youth has been forwarded to the United Women in Faith National Office to Sue Spur. Thank you for both of the, all three of these people for their services.
Sugar plums, sugar plums. You can donate milk gifts. All the kids. about his gifts and stuffed antiques. The bigger the better.
Miss Mouse, usually we seem negative. Are you a little upset by Christmas?
Christmas. Bah, humbug. All it is work and worry and gimme.
Oh no, Christmas is much, much more than that. Let me grab the first edition of The Night Before Christmas, and if that will help you understand. Now settle down and listen.
It was the night before Christ's birth. Up in the sky, the angels were preparing to be heard on high.
Tonight's the night God is sending Jesus down to earth.
I'm so excited. Who should we tell the news to first?
Let me look at tonight's assignment. We are to go to the hills outside Bethlehem to a group of shepherds.
Shepherds, shouldn't we tell some other important people instead?
It's God's plan for you to tell the shepherds first. The birth is just the beginning of the plan.
God knows best. Let's get the other angels and head out.
Come on, guys!
Just getting ready to lay themselves down.
I have so much to do. I have never seen so many people in my life. My place is so full that I've had to turn people away. Just a little while ago, a young couple begged me to let them stay in my stable. I let them. The life is expected of a baby any time now. I suppose it is better than sleeping in the street. Maybe I should check on them? No, they'll be okay.
And down on the hillside were watching their sheep. A group of young shepherds were falling asleep. When suddenly, out of the sky came a light. An angel appeared, making everything bright.
Peace to each man. You need not have fear. For the news we have brought, you'll find very dear.
A baby is born this night as his birth. He comes to save all of the people on earth.
In Bethlehem town, you will find this dear child with Joseph and Mary, his mother so mild.
Sharing a manger with oxen and sheep, snuggled in blankets, the babe sound asleep.
Jesus is born!
Angels delivered the news. The shepherds went searching with no time to lose. And just as the angels had told them aloud, they found Jesus with Mary and Joseph so proud.
In those days, Caesar Augustus made a law. It required that a list be made of everyone in the whole Roman world. It was the first time a list was made of a people while Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone went to their own town to be listed.
So Joseph went also. He went from the town of Nazareth to Galilee to Judea. That is where Bethlehem, the town of David, was. Joseph went there because he belonged to the family line of David. He went there with Mary to be listed. Mary was engaged to him. She was expecting a baby. While Joseph was there, it was time for the child to be born. She gave birth to her first baby. It was a boy. She wrapped him in large strips of cloth, then placed him in a manger because there was no guest room where they could stay.
There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby. It was night, and they were taking care of their sheep. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news. It will bring great joy for all your people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Here's how you will know I'm telling you the truth. You'll find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a large group of angels from heaven also appeared. They were praising God. They said, "May the glory be given to the highest heaven, and may peace be given to those he is pleased with on earth." Person who hears and believes that moment from Jesus, a pardon receives. For all folks have sinned and gone their own way, but God listens closely when we choose to pray and choose to love Jesus, who came down to earth to live and to die and to give us new birth.
Terrific! Christmas isn't all gimme. It can be Jesus and joy and love straight from God.
Now you know the reason for the season!
Thanks, guys!
Before the kids leave, and before the adults, some of the adults leave with them. Sue's going to come up and we have some presentations. Someone is, right? Somebody?
Thanks, Pastor Wayne. We at just at this point would like to invite everyone that has helped with the children's program to please come forward. The students have something to give each and every one of you. Thank you, one and all. Here, Emmett. All right, thank you one and all for helping make this a successful program.
Here at the church, we take up a noisy offering on the third Sunday. So now it's time for the noisy offering. So if I could have my helpers come forward. The noisy offering today will be going to the food pantry. So what that means is you empty out all the change in your pocket or your purse and you dump it into the noisy bucket. Now, I always say paper also makes noise, so you're more than welcome to do that too. But all the proceeds will go to the food pantry. So they're coming forward with the buckets. So let's take up our noisy offering this morning. So we thank you for your contribution to the food pantry. Today, we're going to give up our joys and concerns. And this morning, we need to keep Diana Margis' mother in your prayers for health issues. Also, in your bulletin, on the inside, in the circle of our concern, there are a list of names. Please keep all those individuals in your prayer. We also pray for all those whom we know that we do not mention or say out loud for their own privacy, that are hurting and who need God's healing touch. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today, and we thank you for the children of this church. What a great program to remind us of the reason for the season. It's about your coming here to this earth as a Christ child, as the Messiah. And so, Lord, help us to remember that through all the hustle and bustle of this holiday season. That's all about you and what you've done for us. And so, Lord, this morning we are thankful for everything that you have done for us, all the blessings that you give to us. We are grateful that you love us so much that you are there in our times of joy and happiness, and you are there when we struggle and we have issues. We thank you during this holiday season for our police, fire, EMS, and conservation officers, all who are on duty to come to our aid when we need help. Lord, we're also thankful for our military who are on duty around the world. And no matter what theater of operations that they are in or mission that is assigned to them, Lord, just be with them. And Lord, we're thankful for our healthcare workers. You have given them the knowledge and the skills and abilities in order to help heal us when we are in pain or we are suffering. So Lord, for all of these, we pray for their safety. We pray that you continue to give them all the knowledge that they need to perform the task before them. Lord, we are thankful for this church. We're thankful for the ministries that we have. And we're thankful for a fantastic year of ministry. But Lord, we continue and we march on for the year ahead and the things to come. Lord, we're thankful for all the people here in Hebron, Indiana. Wrap your loving arms around them and let them know that this church is a safe place for them. This is where they can come to be a part of a family, a community, the body of Christ. Lord, we're thankful for all the people who give of their time and their talent and their resources in order for this church to be successful in carrying out your mission to love others, to care for others, to provide for the needy. Thank you. But Lord, we do have issues and we have problems. We have worry and doubt and fear and anxiety. Sometimes we just can't forgive that person who did us wrong or said something to us. So Lord, this morning, as we worship, take those things from our heart and our mind. In fact, we give them to you, and we lay them here at this altar. They now belong to you. Lord, free us from our sin. Free us from those things that hold us back from having a relationship with you. Lord, we lift up all those who are suffering, who have pain, who are struggling with an addiction. Lord, just be with them. Wrap your loving arms around them and hold them tight and let them know that they are loved and that they are being prayed for today in our hearts and our minds and hear out loud. So Lord, be with us as we continue to worship you this morning. And we now say that prayer that you taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. It's now time to continue our worship service by giving of our tithes and offerings to God. So will the ushers please come forward to take up our offering this morning. Father, we ask that you bless these gifts and bless the giver. Lord, take this offering, multiply it to do your work here in this community and in this world. And we say this in your precious name. Amen. You may be seated, and we will now be entertained with more music.
Our scripture reading this morning comes from the book of John 1, verses 6 through 8, and also 19 through 28. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. Now this was John's testimony when the Jewish leaders in Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to ask him who he was. He did not fail to confess, but confessed freely, "I am not the Messiah." They asked him, "Then who are you? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Finally they said, "Who are you? Give us an answer to take back to those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, "I am the voice of the one calling in the wilderness. Make straight the way for the Lord." Now the Pharisees who had been sent questioned him, "Why then do you baptize if you are not the Messiah, nor Elijah, nor the prophet?" "I baptize with water," John replied, "but among you stands one who you do not know. He is the one who comes after me, the straps of whose sandals I am not worthy to untie." This all happened at Bethany on the other side of Jordan, where John was baptizing. For the word of God in Scripture, for the word of God among us, for the word of God within us. Thanks be to God.
So prior to church, I was standing in the back speaking with some men, and I said, "I understand today I get to preach for an hour and a half." And, you know, these guys are great, because one of them said, "That includes eating, right?" So, yeah, it's going to include eating, but what joy, right? We lit the candle of joy this morning. What joy it is to celebrate the birth of Christ, and especially with the children of the church, and with all of you, and the musical selections that we have. A very musical church. I'm not musical. A lot of you know that. So when people hear me sing, joy is not a word that comes forth. But you know, today it is about joy. And this season is about joy. And we have a lot of joy in our lives. I mean, I have extreme amount of joy for a number of things. I remember when my children were first born, each one of them taking them into my arms, and the joy and the happiness was just overwhelming to me. How could I love anything more than this precious little child? I remember the day when my wife said yes to marry me. I was relieved more than anything else. But she said yes. And I remember those days in my own life whenever Army would beat Navy in football. It was an extreme amount of joy, not only for me, but for the entire base. And I remember how joyful it is to open up a bag of Utz potato chips and watch Notre Dame football. See, I've just hit them all, so y'all got it. But we have those times of joy in our lives. We also have those times where sometimes it's not so joyful until later on that we see that it is. But joy is that time of happiness. And so when we talk about joy in our own lives, we're joyful for the kids today, right? Amen. Okay, let's try it one more time. We're joyful for the kids today, right? Yes. Amen. Yes, there we go. That's better. I wasn't sure. I thought people left. But we're joyful for their talents too, that they can give glory to God. And we're joyful for a lot of things in our lives. Maybe we're joyful for, you know, our neighbors. Maybe we're joyful for that person who's driving in front of us at 20 miles an hour when the speed limit's 55. How many of you? I'm not getting some hands, but not a lot. We're joyful when they pull over or turn. We're like, "Thank you, Jesus, you answered my prayer." But we experience those times of joy, but that's not the joy that we're talking about today. Today is about that joy of Jesus Christ. Because we're anticipating the birth of the Christ child, and the Advent candles, we're getting closer. Only got one more candle to light, and then we light the Christ candle on Christmas Eve at the 11 p.m. service. So it's getting closer. And in case you didn't know, Christmas is 1 week away. And I'm not trying to create any anxiety for any of you, but it is only 1 week. What joy. What joy. We anticipate not only the birth of Christ, but anticipate time spending with family. Now, you're probably all wondering, well, what's the scripture got to do? John the Baptist, what does he have to do with any of this? How do we find joy in John the Baptist? A guy who hung out in the desert and who wore very little clothing, smelled probably immensely, and he hangs out at the river and he's preaching. So how many of you would come this morning if I dressed that way and I didn't take a shower and I stood up here and I started preaching? How many of you would be so joyful? Yeah. We're joyful. I didn't, correct? But here's John the Baptist and he's preaching and he's baptizing people in the river for the redemption, forgiveness of their sins. And the priest and the Pharisees and all the other people were standing around there saying, wait a minute, that's not what we've been taught. That's not what John has been taught. Aren't we supposed to go to the temple to do that? Aren't we supposed to sacrifice something for the forgiveness of our sins? What is he doing? Why is he doing this? And so they go and question him, and he answers their questions. And he doesn't beat around the bush. He says, I'm just preparing the way. There's someone greater who's coming. Because they say, are you the Messiah? Are you the one? Are you the Christ? No. Another one is coming. Someone else greater than me. In fact, biblical scholars tell us that John was the greatest who was ever born, because Jesus said that. John was the greatest man who was ever born on the face of the earth, because he was bringing the good news of redemption. He's preparing the way. He's preparing the hearts of the people. Last week, we talked about you have to have peace, and John the Baptist was trying to infuse that into the people. There's peace. Prepare their hearts that there's hope. And today there's joy. So John the Baptist, who looks a lot, probably a lot like Jesus, they were cousins, he says, I am unworthy to even take off the sandals of the one who is to come. You see, the lowliest servant in the household, the lowliest one, was the one who was tasked with that job, is to take off people's sandals when they came to the house and to wash their feet clean of the dirt and the grime. And John says, I'm not even worthy of that. John was spreading the joy that someone better is coming, that Jesus Christ is coming. That's the joy. And that's the joy that we should have during this busy time. We're going to have parties. We're going to have fudge. And we're going to open presents. And we're going to have times of getting together with our family. Those are great and marvelous things. And they are joyful times. But let's not forget the true joy. The true meaning is in Jesus Christ. Because the joy of Christ living within us and being a part of us lasts for eternity, not just for a moment. You know, when my wife said yes to me, when I asked her to marry me, it was a moment. And it has lasted so far a lifetime. There are times when I do stuff and I go, that wasn't very joyful. Wasn't a good time. She's not joyful with me. But they still are only here for this earth. But our relationship with Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, the King of Kings, if we can sing hallelujah and say, that is joy. That is joyful. So I'd like for you to leave here today remembering the joy that you experience with your kids or the grandkids, or maybe they're just people you know. But the joy that they are celebrating the Christ child coming. And we need to remember that for this season. It's all about Jesus coming here as a child. And so in regards to that, we also remember of his second coming. He first came as a child, but now he will come. And we look forward to that day with joy and hope and peace and love in our hearts. That he will come again at the time of resurrection where we can live with him. So it's a joyous season. So let's remember that as we leave here today. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have called us to be your servant. You have called us to spread joy and love and hope and happiness to others and to spread peace. But Lord, we can only do that because we have that in our own hearts. And so, Lord, help us to take all the anxiety that we might be holding up during this Christmas season. Help us to release it and see the joy in the many things that you provided for us. Help us to see the joy of what Christmas is about the birth of Jesus the Christ, the Messiah, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who have come to save us, to forgive us of our sins. And so, Lord, we ask that you surround us. We ask for your protection. But most of all, we ask that you come inside of our hearts today to spread that message to others. We say this in your precious name. Amen.
We stand and join us in our final song. Now, you notice the title. Come on, stand up. You notice the title up there says Joy to the World. I don't know anybody that says that has joy in their heart who's frowning. So maybe smile, put some joy in your heart, joy in your voice, and sing to the Lord this morning.
Joy to the world.
Joy to the world, the Savior brings, let all their sorrows fill.
Oh, go ahead. You can clap for me. See, I knew you were clapping for them, not for me. So, I'm going to say the prayer as a benediction for our food. So you can just go straight back into the back room, and they'll be ready for you. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for the joy and the hope and the love and the peace that is in this place. And so, Lord, as we go and partake of this brunch, we ask that you bless the food, bless those who prepared it for us, and most of all, Lord, bless us in our fellowship as we continue to worship you this morning. And we say this in your precious name. Amen. Go in peace.
Joy, unspeakable joy, an overflowing well, no time can tell. Joy, unspeakable joy, rises in my soul.
Go with joy in your hearts today, and joy as you eat.